Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Beth, if you are new here. Today's video is gonna be exciting. This is my second ever makeup video. And today we are gonna be doing it in a different light. So as you can tell, we have the Beach Boys in the background. Today we are going to be listening to 60s music. I have a 60s playlist that I curated, and if you guys like it, it's linked down below. I'm going to be trying out the famous 60s eye look. I've always wanted to try it. This is not a tutorial, I'm just kind of having fun with you guys and listening to music and getting into that 60s mindset because I truly was born in the wrong decade. Even the fact that we have Harry Styles, can we just put him in the 60s and then I could be born? Whatever. We'll be doing the famous Sharon Tate twiggy eye look. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. I do have one other makeup video, but in that video I put on way too much blush, and I blame that to the fact that I wear glasses and I have to take them off to do my makeup, and I'm very blind and there was no mirror anywhere near me. Yeah, but if you want a link to a product, you can just go ahead and reach out to me. So for primer, I'm going in with the Becca First Light Priming Filter. This stuff is so freaking good. I think primer sometimes doesn't do anything, but this is the only primer I've had where I feel like it genuinely does something. We'll never change foundations, not until forever. I've had this since 8th grade. So this is the Infallible Pro Matte Foundation in from L'Oreal in shade 103 Natural Buff. Like I said, we have the playlist going. This is Sunday Morning by the Velvet Underground. And yes, I do have blueberry cheesecake on my phone, a sticker. I love cheesecake.
Why did I bring this cake?
I don't know.
That reminds me of one of my favorite YouTubers ever. She was like, I got some blueberry stuff. Blueberries, love their work.
Blueberries, love their work.
All right, and then now for concealer, I am going into the Florence by Millie Bobby Brown concealer in the shade L055. I had said in my last video, it's kind of funny, that I really wanted to try the the Millie Bobby Brown concealer. Touching you, sweet Caroline, bum, bum, bum. So, comment down below your favorite song from the 60s. For me, it's hard. I really, really like... I know Happy Together is on this list. I love that song. I don't know the exact year that came out. I also love anything Joni Mitchell, Both Sides Now. Joni Mitchell is queen. I sit this close to a mirror when I do my makeup and I sit on the floor. But to film a video, you can't do that. So I'm really struggling because I'm unable to see the mirror over there. And then this, I don't want to block myself. I was jamming at the High School Musical this morning. Do you guys still jam off High School Musical? If your answer is no, get off my channel. We wouldn't be friends in real life. For to set all my wet ingredients, I'm going into the It Cosmetics by Pore Pressed Powder. My next video is so freaking good. I filmed it yesterday with one of my best friends. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm really, really excited for you guys to see this. I don't know why, but I'm thinking of that. I'm just kind of thinking of, you know, this time and in the 70s and thinking of the movie Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and you know that tweet that's like, I'm gonna create an environment that's so toxic. Like Jane Lynch, they said Margot Robbie in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, it was black. There was no words. For bronzer and contour, I kind of mixed those two things together. I'm going into this Ofra Midi Palette Sweet Electric, and it has three things in it. It has blush, bronzer, and highlighter. I love the bronzer and the highlighter are so, so good. I'm not that fond on the blush though because it's too light for me. So I'm just gonna go ahead and dip into this. If you guys are wondering, the rings that I wear in my videos are right now. I wear the same three rings every single day. So I have this one on this hand. This is my TPWK Harry Styles ring that I wear every day. Then I have this one that is a wave for my college. And then I have this one that has my class and name of my high school. Oh, shoot. A tiny, tiny, tiny bit of a blush from this e.l.f. palette. Honestly, I've had this palette for so many years and it's amazing because it has this one color in here, this one that's the most used. It's a coral and it has glitter in it. It's so pretty. This is a matte cream blush by Rare Beauty in the shade Love. This is Selena Gomez's cosmetic line. And I had wanted to try one of these for so bad because she did a video with Nikki Tutorials where she tried out and her blush. And I loved her blush. I have a thing for blush. I love blush. And it looked so doll-like and pretty. And cream blush, I feel like, is so hard to do. I don't know why. For highlight, I have two that I love to go into. So this first one is K-O-K-I-E. It is so beautiful because it has a really pretty, like, holographic purple tint to it. And it just looks really unique, giving me some Euphoria vibes. They're like, I keep trying to whisper because I consume an unhealthy amount of ASMR. The second highlighter that I go into is this Fenty Beauty highlighting stick in Yacht Club. It is so pretty. It has it's like pink and orange with a gold tint. Really, really pretty. So I just go ahead and like scribble it onto my fingers. And then I put this on my nose and all the surrounding areas, but not on my cheekbones yet. I do also like to put some blush on my forehead and my nose to look sunburned, sun-kissed. Down there. With all this stuff and this music, I'm just so fascinated in this world. I don't know if you guys are interested in this world as well, you should watch Echo in the Canyon, that documentary. I saw it a while back in the theater, when theaters were a thing. I'm posting this in February, so I don't know what's going on. I hope good things. It's so good. It's about Laurel Canyon and just the making that in these neighborhoods where the Beach Boys and the Beatles and all these amazing people were creating music, and it's a really amazing documentary kind of on all of that. I'm gonna go to Laurel Canyon one day. I live in LA right now, so it's amazing just to like go for a drive down Sunset and just like listen to this music and feel like you're living in history. I love it. If you guys are wondering, this dress is from Goodwill. I found it, and I think it's supposed to be a nightgown. And then for my brows, I'm going into it with the Florence by Millie Bobby Brown brow tint in the shade brown. Never really done this. I should have practiced or watched a tutorial. Yes, that is green and glittery. No idea where it's from. And for primer, I'm going into the Stuck on You Eye Primer Paint Pot by The Beauty Crop. This kind of reminds me a lot of the, oh my god, it smells like flour, like baking flour. I literally smell it every day before I put it on my eyes. If anyone saw me, they're like, this girl has a problem. Is all of this is cruelty free. I mean, if something isn't and it slipped through me, please let me know. I'm not sure about the L'Oreal Girl Lactic, and this is in Black Noir. And I'm just gonna go ahead, instead of like trying to do this on my eye, because liquid eyeliner and me do not belong together. We did not match on Tinder. I have to do the bottom part and then the lashes. So if you guys are wondering, I just did the bottom and the top. So we only have one more, and it's the little lashes on the bottom. And I fixed it up with my tiny little miniature Tarte Shape Tape in the shade, I think, Golden Honey. Yeah, I did this look, so I'm going back in with that same eyeliner. And this is actually the hardest part. You would think it'd be the fun, like the easiest part, because you're just making lines, but I found it to be super ticklish when I tried it the first time, and hard. So I'm gonna go ahead and prop this up. You know what, no, I'm just gonna go ahead and, honestly, this has gone better than I thought it would go, so I'm just gonna kinda go with it. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Iris Apatow with the Apatow family, like, you know, Judd Apatow, whatever. But his daughter, Iris Apatow, she is adorable, and her style is the best thing I've ever seen. She is, I don't know why, but I feel like she represents, like, the cultivation of, like, modern 60s. Okay, after I curl my lashes, I'm going to go into my mascara. I wear two mascaras because I have an obsession with, like, really long eyelashes for some reason. And I'm lucky that naturally my eyelashes are pretty long, but to me, I'm like, You know, this is the Milk Mascara, the Kush Mascara. So down below is my February playlist. You guys know I make playlists every single month. Links, my link tree if you want to see my articles for the newspaper that I work on. My Depop I also included in there. I put up some new items yesterday that I'm actually really excited about. Okay, next I'm going into my second mascara, and this is the CoverGirl Total Tease. Every single one of my brushes just fell on the ground because I crashed into everything. So I guess you could say things are going really, like, according to plan. And I said this in my first lookbook. My second lookbook is coming out very soon, by the way. I'm going to film it when you're watching this, actually, in 2 days. I'm going to film it. So I'm very excited. But I get tons and tons of inspiration from Megan from Mad Men. That character and that kind of era. I also get tons of inspiration from Lord's closet from the Melodrama World Tour. If you guys Google those things and look at those outfits, it's super entertaining. I promise you'll be scrolling for hours. Lips, I'm going into this Milani lipstick in the shade 77 Matte Tender. It is so, so beautiful. Are as well done. I'm going to go ahead and set everything with my e.l.f. makeup set and mist, and then I have my handy dandy little fan like last time. I am working on new original music too, by the ways. I recently, last night, just finished a song that has taken me so long. I don't know why this song has been the hardest song for me to write and to finish. But dry, I'm also going to go into my favorite perfume at the moment. I thought I would show you. This is the Bath & Body Works Margarita Cupcake. I think it is so pretty. It's funny because I don't really like citrusy stuff, but I love the way citrus looks. It's very 60s, 70s, all the decor with the lemons on it, having lemon tablecloths. That is definitely me and my thing. So I kind of just like the way the bottle looks, but it smells so good. I'm not into super sour, citrusy scents, but they mixed floral with a tiny bit of orange, and it smells absolutely incredible. And I've never really gotten anything from Bath & Body Works before. I'm actually not mad at how this came out, considering it is kind of a hard thing to get the art. I hope you guys like this video. It'll probably get copyrighted because of all the music, as it should. But if you guys did like it, don't forget to comment down below and chat with me. I love to chat with you guys, or reach out to me on Twitter, which is the social media hub, Bethy, B-E-T-H-Y-Y-S-T-Y-L-E-S for styles. I understand that every decade has its problems and issues, and we're living in the problems and issues right now. So I just hope that you are doing really well and you're keeping yourself happy and safe and healthy mentally as well. That's super, if not more important. I forgot to tell you, but I changed it when I was looking at it to a red lip because I felt like it matched the outfit and the dress, and the eye is very dark, so I felt like it matched it better than not pink. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye!